come with what I have and what I don't, and he can supply me with both. That's all I can offer. I have to come with what I have, and where I'm lacking, I have to come with that too. Then he has the opportunity to engage with me with what I have and help me with the plus stuff that I don't.
You died for my sins.
Breathe your spirit into my heart once again.
Receive you, Holy Spirit.
Into my soul.
In my spirit.
I thank you for healing.
Salvation.
I celebrate you, God. Jeff, if you could come forward and help me with the elements. Everybody just come up. If you want to participate, just come on up. Let them come to you, Jeff. cross over and fully believe. No matter who you think you are or how you act in front of other people, you're just like everybody else. You need a Savior. Admit to God and start admitting to the other people around you. This is who I am, Lord Jesus, and I need Jesus. If you're in that process point where it's just Jesus ain't coming out that often, invite the people around you to pray with you. Just humble yourself. As you humble yourself before other people, that's proof you're humbling yourself to God. Look at your life. If there are sins, confess them. Trust that He's forgiven you. Trust that by His blood, He's wiping you clean. You can come to Him with a clean and sincere heart. He was broken for you that you will never have to have punishment for your sin. You'll never have to experience that. He died for us. Thank you, Lord. You're an awesome God. And the night that Jesus was betrayed, He took bread and He broke it. And He says, eat. Do this in remembrance of me. They're having a conversation, they're having a meal, they're connecting with Jesus. It's all in relationship. This isn't just a transaction, this is a relationship of life. After supper, Jesus took the cup and says, "This is my cup, shed my blood for the forgiveness of your sins. Drink it and do it." Lord, we thank you. Thank you that you are an awesome God. Thank you, God, for loving us. We proclaim that you died for us, and we're going to continue to have communion to the day you come back in anticipation that you not only saved us from the penalty of sin, that you're saving us from the power of sin. And someday when we see you face to face, we'll be saved from the very presence of sin. You not only save us from things, you save us for a purpose. Lord, I pray that your purposes, your very purpose, your very reason that you have us on this earth will become clear. That we do not live for ourselves, for our own kingdom, but we live for your kingdom. Help us to pray, your kingdom come, my kingdom go. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name.
About the rooms that you've invited him into and the ones you haven't. You know, And the old saying is, we all have a skeleton in the closet. We all have some, one room or an area. You know, I have a messy kitchen table. That drives Michael crazy, but and I have a messy spare bedroom too that still hasn't been cleaned up. But Jesus will clean that area up for us. I mean, he'll clean up any dirty old closet or the musty old basement if we allow him, you know. But if we keep him out, you know, you can come in this room.